Hey everybody, welcome back. Northern Lion plays the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. We did random Eden. What, the random is Isaac, so let's random again. I'm ready. Cain? Judas? Judas! Okay, so we gotta be on our ball here. Not directly on the ball. That might cause some actual long-lasting damage. I am immediately... there's no, camera setup going on here, so you guys don't know this, but my microphone cord is dangling precipitously close to my hands right now, slightly fucking up my mojo. Let's get it going over here. That's better. Yeah, okay, that's not gonna interfere. The keyboard setup, man, it's got a lot to do with how you play in Isaac, because it gives you an excuse. You know, anytime you have an excuse, it makes it easier to fail, because you know in the back of your head, if you fail, you can pull out the excuse. If you got no excuse, it adds a much more, this is my psychological, sports psychology reasoning here. It adds a, you know, an extra element of danger to the loss. An element of shame, and as such, you find yourself actively working to avoid that whenever possible. Really thought that would find a secret room there, but that's okay. I really thought that we'd get anything at all that was good, but that's okay too. I feel like I'm playing as the Lost right now. I don't know why, but I think because I went through that period where I went through like 50 runs in a row without playing Judas. Not of my own design. Oh good, here we fucking go. It's guaranteed to be... No, it's not a... it's not a message from Mathis. I mean, dude was shit-talking... Or I was shit-talking him, which is why I thought that it would be a message from him being like, ha-ha, I fucked up your Rebirth run. We did our roundtable. Like, roundtable is a podcast that we do with myself, Bear, Mathis, and Nick. And it operates on like a once every 2 weeks schedule. I'd say bi-weekly, but then, you know, it comes with the obvious question. Was bi-weekly twice a week or once every 2 weeks? Fortnightly, let's put it that way. Once every 2 weeks. 1 week on a Tuesday, we have a podcast that we record that goes up on Friday. And then the Tuesday after that, we do a multiplayer stream. And then the following Friday, we do a podcast and then a multiplayer stream. You get the idea. Oh, not very good damage there. Let's be very cautious here. This could go terribly wrong. In fact, I'm going to pop up a Belial on this stream just to hopefully be able to one-shot these flies. We did our stream today. This is at 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Sorry, 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, which is where he lives. So I was up at 11. Not difficult, because I'm an adult who has responsibilities and handles them. This motherfucker was late. He slept for 12 hours, then showed up and was like, what the... Whoa, I didn't know what was going on. I'm sorry, I didn't set my phone to charge, and then it ran out of batteries in the middle of the night. What are you doing, mate? It's like, I don't understand it, man. Oh my god. This isn't his first rodeo, you know? He's nearly a 30-year-old man, sort of, with like a fiancé and responsibilities. I don't get, how does it happen? I don't know, man. Anyway, so I figured he was trying to get some revenge on me for that. Now he's gonna get revenge on me for shit-talking him in this video. He's a great dude, but man, he's gotta get his sleep shit sorted out. It was really his own fault. He's like, I can't help it, I slept for 12 hours, my phone ran out of batteries. Well, you freaking charge it. He's like, is that 20% when I fell asleep? What kind of savage doesn't charge their phone when it's at 20%? It's probably not going to run out of batteries at 20%, but what, do you want to wake up with your phone being at 0% battery or 1% battery? Yeah, that's way better than taking 2 freaking seconds to plug it in at night. What are you smoking? And can I have some? We've gotten very lucky with HP on this floor, by the way. We could easily have found ourselves way, way more fucked than we actually have been. And we're going to be fine for consumables, it looks like, as well. I'm a little salty we didn't get HP. But we at least have the spirit heart backing us up. I can't remember, by the way, if I've been to an item room or if I have not been to an item room. We'll do a little bit more exploring until I can feel a little bit more confident in my conclusion. We have not been to our item room. Yeah, okay. Smartfly is really good. And then I will probably buy a spirit heart in here. Well, Northern Lion, though, you're going to ruin your chance for an arcade. You're not wrong, my son slash daughter. My secret son. However, we don't need an arcade because we only have half a red heart. We might get to one full red heart. La di flippin' da. That's not going to help us out all that much. I'd rather just have the extra spirit heart for some peace of mind, not only for a deal with the devil, but just for some raw-ass survival. And you know that, oh baby, I like it raw. Two keys, that's good. One bomb, hopefully we'll be able to leverage that for a tinted rock. It's all about leveraging your consumables here in the early game and also not taking damage that precludes you from getting a deal with the devil or just precludes you from being alive. I'm not that salty about being on the cellar, by the way, because the basement pretty much just fucked us on the last one. And by fucked us, I mean I allowed myself to take some shitty damage as a result of being on it, but that's okay. We'll get out of it. I'm used to playing... What I was going to say before the Skype message came in was I think I ruined my Judas foo to some extent during that phase of randoms where we didn't get Judas for like 7 videos in a row, and by 7 I mean like 50. I do want that spirit heart, but I'd rather use my bomb for a more guaranteed payout, like luckily this one right here. Now we got another bomb, but I worry that I'm going to take damage in the process. I would like to take hookworm, I sincerely would, however I'm gonna hold off on it. Just because this is a very, very important floor. So we got the Magician, and we did pick up a Blackheart. Wasn't a guaranteed payout, but it was a nice payout. The Magician card's just kind of like a little bit of icing here. I don't agree with that phrase, by the way, the icing on the cake. Oh, this is the icing on the cake. Which is like, the cake is the main part, the icing is the just bonus, right? I don't agree with that. If you had a cake without icing, I think you would say like, yeah, this is like... It's kind of a boring cake, unless it was like absolutely delicious. I think that cake would have a bit of a marketing problem, a perception issue to work out on its hands, you know? Probably should have used Book of Belial on this room, but it's alright. You may disagree, maybe your favorite part of the cake is the cake and not the icing, but I don't think that's necessarily common. So we should probably, if possible, use the credit card on what looks to be a nearly guaranteed deal with the devil. Well, it should be guaranteed deal with the devil because of Book of Belial. I always forget that early on in Judas runs. Of course you have to fight the haunt, that's just a prerequisite. If you're on second floor cellar, it will be the haunt. It's Haunt's Law. Not quite as prolific as Monstro's Law, but it's up there. We'll probably get through this fight only getting hit maybe once. I say once, not because I'm cocky, but because after we get hit once, we'll have Revenge Fly, and Revenge Fly will just tear the ass end out of the haunt. It won't even be a concern. Good stuff. Okay. The HP up is nice, especially if we're just going to trade away. The only reason we won't use credit card, by the way, is because if we get like Whore of Babylon or something in here. Okay, well, tell you what. This is actually kind of a nice opportunity to use this because Judas's Shadow for free basically nullifies the complaint that I would have had about Judas's Shadow, which is that it's too expensive and doesn't really do that much for us in our current situation. Did we get Revenge Fly? Revenge Fly was from... This floor, no, last floor is deal with the item room. That's what I was gonna say the whole time. What are you talking about? So I think that we still need to get to our item room. I hate starting with curses, man. Like starting with Curse of the Unknown or starting with Curse of the Blind can be really, really. It's hard to get your calibration set right. Like I have no idea what rooms we've gone to as a result of this. I'll use Book of Belial on this room. I really like. It's a bad habit. Luckily, it rarely bites me in the ass. Like, Judas, he's ended a few streaks of mine, but I normally play half decently with him, I think. But it's always for the best to get more of the, more out of your spacebar items. Like, why wouldn't you? Why wouldn't you want to, at least? I will say that we actually are closing in on Lord of the Flies, I think. We got 2 different fly items already. Admittedly, it's a mechanic that I'm a little bit fuzzy on, but I think with 3 fly items... We've already been here, probably, right? Oh, yeah, we've definitely already been here. This is our starting room. With 3 fly... Or if we get 3 fly items, I think we get it. It might be 4, though, but even a pretty fly pill, I think, will do it at this point. Which is pretty common. Which is basically just nice for the ability to fly. I wouldn't mind taking the Magician card, but I also wouldn't mind taking the Death card. So, either way is okay by me. I think there's not much interest that I have personally in going to our, I hate this situation. I'm gonna save my bomb, actually, for future Tinted Rocks. I really don't like Hookworm with, like, vanilla tiers, but we'll try it. It could be weird. We don't need a battery charge, and we're just good to go. I don't want to try to find a second secret room. Just a little too iffy right now. Yeah, it's not the best floor, but... We could get a free or very easy ability to fly as a result of that as a result of the Lord of the Flies kind of potential we've got going on here. So what is our main advantage right here on this run? Well, unlimited deals with the devil means we can't not ball out of control if we live long enough and have the HP to actually take deals. So there's that's going to help out a little bit right there, a health upgrade for free. I was going to say followed by a health downgrade, but no, we got a range downgrade, which is technically not terrible. I think this is a decent time to use our death card. Admittedly, a little disappointed that the enemies didn't die right away. Daddy Longlegs, another great item. And this is interesting. I think I'm going to wait. We can just do it right now. That's fine, actually. I was going to wait until we had bombs, but actually, we got bombs right there. I wonder if, like, Daddy Longlegs, if I can get one of the silkworms over here. Daddy Longlegs could step on it. Might as well double our HP right now. There are better ways to do it, I guess, but... like, Daddy Longlegs, if it steps on the chest, it has a chance to open it, right? There's no way this doesn't end in disaster for me. Oh! It stepped as close to directly on the chest as you can get there and did not open it, so... I'm gonna go ahead and say that that myth is busted. We'll open it anyway. Hope for a cricket's head, maybe? Guppy's head? That's alright. It's a guppy item at the very least and gives us three extra flies, which is already, like, a pretty good payout for a room. Probably should have used Book of Belial on our last room, considering we were fighting a lot of enemies and there was a battery available anyway. Joker? Joker. So the way that we should probably... I'll come back to that room. I might like to get an early Steam sale. The way that we should probably use the Joker card is to save it for the Cathedral. I can't guarantee that that's how this is going to go down. Because... well, that's really bad. Because... thanks a lot, Hookworm. Because I might just, you know, have a better card that I want to save longer. You know, if we have a Sun card and a lot of HP, that might be the way that that goes down. Ooh, careful. Or, you know, if we want to teleport out of this room, for example, we might want to do it that way. But I'd rather not lose a Joker card if possible as well. So, like, I'm not going to just teleport out of this room, even though I provided that as a thought experiment. Can Daddy Longlegs blow up rocks if it lands on top of them? How am I going to get an enemy directly over this rock? That's probably a more pertinent question. Taking some dumb damage, largely as a result of Hookworm, but I'm hoping that we pick up a Brimstone or something to make this Hookworm look awesome as all heck. Bomb? Yeah, we'll check it out, because if we get two Joker cards, we can use one guilt-free right now. It might be a two of spades or something. It's another Joker. Alright, let's get that done. Angel Room. Tell you what, we'll take Celtic Cross. If I could blow up that angel statue, I would, but we can't. Celtic Cross is good. I would have preferred some Devil Precedent. Why do we not have Devil Precedent? I took Judas's Tongue on the last... or not Judas's Tongue, Judas's Shadow on the last item room. Maybe it doesn't count... there, an excuse to get rid of Hookworm. Maybe it doesn't count as Deal with the Devil Precedent unless you actually pay HP for it. That would change the game very, very slightly. Just one of those, like, Isaac things you'd like to know to play optimally. If that's the case, I would have rather paid, like, out of pocket, basically, for the Judas's Shadow and then had Deal with the Devil Precedent. But maybe we'll end up having an interesting run regardless. Well, it's already an interesting run. I'm not going to say we've learned something, but it's possible that we've learned something. Alright, well, we're gonna get a Deal with the Devil item here, regardless, so I can stop my bitching, I guess. Nice. However, I think I will fight the Angel Statue as well, just for shits and giggles, basically. We'll get the Goat Head, so I could replace Book of Belial if I wanted to. I don't really want to, though. I like the damage bonus for Book of Belial. If we get, like, D6 or something, now we would probably replace Book of Belial with it, but short of getting the D6, I don't think, we're going to be that interested in that. Alright, easy key piece. Did lose a little bit of HP to make it happen, but that's okay. I may or may not actually end up fighting Mega Satan, but we might as well give it the, you know, old college try. And let's maybe not spend anything on this floor now, because if we don't spend any money, we've got a much better chance of getting an arcade, and we actually do have the HP necessary to play the arcade. If we wanted to, we could even kill ourselves on the arcade. Or elsewhere, even if we wanted to, and respawn as Dark Judas for that sweet damage bonus, but that'll depend on how many spirit hearts we can kind of finagle, you know? In fact, I'm kind of interested in just doing it right now and then restarting with four hearts. Like, I feel like you should always do it as soon as possible. If there's gotta be fires, or like I can go to a cursed room or something like that. Did I leave any fires or spikes or anything open? The shop has to have them. Should probably hit the fire from the other side just so we don't get hurt on the way out. Alright, Celtic Cross is active. So if you're wondering what the heck I'm doing here, I am making an executive decision to start our Judas's Shadow run. I figure, you know, what's the point of having Judas's Shadow if you don't use it? I'm going to like the extra damage bonus here, and we have a good opportunity to pick up the extra Spirit Hearts right now and give us a decent amount of HP moving forward. If we're not going to be getting consistent deals with the devil, my hypothesis is that we'd really very much like to have a little bit more of a damage bonus, because that's the attribute that you're most commonly going to miss out on by not getting those deals with the devil. Let's hope this works out in a way that's not terrible for me. And I came back and bought the Spirit Heart, even though I said I would buy nothing, because we could probably use it now just to maybe give us a little bit more hope of surviving. But I think we're going to be in a pretty good state here. I think so, at least. Yeah. Let's move along. Goodbye, Hookworm. I'm really getting into this, the meta, or I'm buying in, I should say, to the meta that, you know, tactical suicide, even with a Suicide King card, can actually be beneficial for you. It is a high-risk strategy in, like, almost every possible situation you'd use it in, but I think it's more often than not good. I got kind of trapped between a rock and a hard place there. This is gonna sound fucked up, but for as much as, you know, the black lipstick might help us out here, I really, really like Flatworm. I like the way it makes our tears look. I'm gonna stick with it, man. I think it's a fan favorite as well, and that really shows how simple we are as creatures, right? That it's basically just like, just makes our tears look slightly different, like elongated, and everyone, myself included, is like, that's funny. I don't know what it is, man. I like it though, man. I am gonna sacrifice a Spirit Heart right off the bat to go into our curse room. We got Guppy Dreams. They're multiplying. Unfortunately, that did not work out for us, but this is a calculated risk. It was a calculated risk. It wasn't quite a Shatner impression. It's getting into that vein, though. Yeah, you want to mainline those Shatner impressions so they get into your bloodstream faster. Okay, let's see what this is. I don't want to reroll this run, because I've already really done a lot to design it myself. Hermit card. Joker card's better for us, obviously. We're not going to be doing boss rush on this run anyway. It would save us a key. So actually, if we're going to just, like, not use it for boss rush, why don't we just Hermit card right now to save a key? And I think these items still pretty much suck, so we'll just buy another Spirit Heart. To minimize the risk of me leaving that Joker card behind, let's just backtrack for it, like, literally right now. We'll go back this way. Even if our boss room could be here, I don't want to forget about it. It's just one room away. Daddy Longleg's so good at fighting enemies like Fistula. Just breaks all the parts simultaneously. Usually. Like, against a Fistula, it can actually just KO it in one hit. Same with an Envy. It has to be kind of a perfect situation, but it gets the job done. Tempting. Not tempting at all. I don't think we need to pick it up, either. Like, that doesn't do anything for us. It did in vanilla, but those are different days, man. It's another decent amount of money. Still not sure what I'm going to use that for. We have not had the shops of the highest pedigrees so far. It's possible, by the way, that if we get a deal with the devil, we're going to have to make, like, an executive decision. Do we take the deal with the devil item, which will give us the item, but also ruin our deal with the angel precedent? Or do we forego it to try to do deals with the angels so we can actually fight Mega Satan? I'm not really the biggest fan of fighting Mega Satan as, like, a novelty, but, you know, we already got one of the key pieces, so it kind of seems like that might be viable. Hematemesis again. If we get Dark Bum, I mean, these are huge payouts. And we don't get Dark Bum, they're kind of shitty. Which is how it's looking so far. What I would really like is just deal with the angel on this floor and then give me deals with the devil in the future. Like, that's the happy medium. Even if the deal with the angel item is shitty, I could sleep peacefully knowing that happened. Alright, I will take experimental treatment. Doesn't seem like it hurt us that much. You know what? Fuck it. They're good. They're not good enough to make me give up the Mega Satan dream. The right play is I mean, either of those, probably not both, but either of those is the right play. The Nail, because we already have Goathead, so we can get the deals with the devil anyway, give you a nice Spirit Heart boost. And, of course, Lord of the Pitches gives you the ability to fly, which is fine. Ooh, that's bad. This is all not good. Alright, that one, that might have even made it all worthwhile, weirdly enough. But yeah, I'm going to stick with our potential deal with the Angel precedent. If we get a better deal with the devil, I probably won't hesitate to take it. However, that deal with the devil was just not quite good enough, even though it was probably objectively the right choice to take something on it. It's just not good enough. Guppy items, please. Oh, yeah, silkworms. Oh, fuck this room, man. Daddy Longlegs, I hope you've been working on your reflexes, man. Gotta be a little faster than that. There's more? There we go. Oh, there's a couple more. That wasn't so bad, actually. Probably as a direct result of using Book of Belial, but anyway. Thank you, Daddy Longlegs. Thank you, Daddy Longlegs. Sounds weird to say that. No grown man, unless they know what they're getting into, should be saying thank you, Daddy. If you're into that sort of thing, that's absolutely fine. Even if I was, I wouldn't necessarily want to be, you know, broadcasting it here live on YouTube.tv/NorthernLion. Northern Lion messed up his name. His URL. His branding's all fucked. What a loser. Okay. Let's continue to go to these huge rooms, apparently. I mean, this one's actually, like, a pretty easy big room. I'm almost hoping we have a greed fight here. Just, like, give me the steam sale for free, then make me fight super greed on the next floor, and then make me fight greed again on the floor after it, because shops have been not so good anyway. Sharp Plug is a great item that I do not know how to use properly. The map, in and of itself, is a huge mapping help. I mean, that sounds self-evident, but the map was not really that strong in vanilla, in my opinion at least. And I thought it actually got worse in Rebirth because it doesn't show you secret rooms anymore. But actually, now I've learned to just live with it, and it's kind of nice. It can pretty easily help you get those, get the right direction on the womb and beyond. And probably before that, but before that, it's a little bit less of a concern. Alright, so we're hoping for, like, just one more deal with the angel. There should be an angel version of Krampus. There's an easy expansion idea for you. Then you should buff angel rooms so that you see them more often, so you can actually fight the angel version of Krampus. Deal with the angel, so we're definitely going to, oh, and the mine makes it so I really wish I didn't buy the map, but, still, the mine is a great item. And I've heard that the body cannot live without it, according to Morpheus. Please, please, I need you to die. Thank you. Alright, we got two key pieces. We can now guilt-free take deals with the devil. If they want to give me more deals with the angel on the caliber of the map, then sign me up, man. I'd be interested in that. Interesting. The little gish payout is totally fine. You can see that there is a dice room. I really don't want to reroll this run because I've already done the clever stuff with Judas's shadow. I mean, time will tell whether it's truly clever, I guess. Please, please. Time will tell whether it's truly clever or not, but, we're gonna see what it is before we really freak out. It could just end up being a four-room or a three-room, or, honestly, ideally, it would be a five-room. I talk about that all the time now, but the five-rooms are, like, objectively really, really good. Depending on the floor you're on and depending on what you're looking for, at least, the five-room is just a forget-me-now, but you get to keep your spacebar item, which is rare, man. So I'm not going to use two keys to get all those bombs, because I'm already going to use two keys to get into our special room here, just to at least see what it is. We know it's dice. Not a one or a six. It's a two. Rerolls consumables, I think. As far as I'm concerned, if I left a consumable on the ground, there's probably a reason, so maybe we got some good rerolls out of that. We'll see, though. Two room, one of the, like, least impactful, but in a way that's a good thing. I'm happy we didn't have to worry about a six room. Crystal Bowl. Crystal Ball is really, really good. And especially when we have low HP, that's something we might be interested in, but I'm choosing to not take it because I really do. I think Book of Belial is maybe the best spacebar item in the game. Even though we have the goat head, I still think Book of Belial might be our trump card here. I gotta start using it more often, though, if I'm gonna really stick by that claim. Come on, one guppy item, one guppy item. We'll use it here on this room for sure. We're a little bit behind the eight ball. Oh, awesome. A little bit behind the eight ball in terms of, like, our deal with the devil pace right now, because we took two deals with the angel. And we might not be guaranteed any more deals with the devil, which is, I think, no specific with the devil. We'll definitely get deals, but they could be exclusively with the angel. But we can make up for that a little bit because we have this Joker card that we can use on the cathedral to get one deal that we shouldn't otherwise get. So, did I place a bomb by accident? That was just a... I fat-fingered it a little bit. Basically, I think we can get back ahead of the curve here on deals with the devil, but it's going to be a bit of a shit show. We should win this run, but it's not quite set in stone yet. Need some more damage. I was going to say we need a reliable way to replenish our HP as well, but that's kind of rich considering, you know, I just got rid of the crystal ball. This is a weird run of, like, overlapping uses. Like, we have the map, but we also have the mind. And then we got Crystal Ball, but we also have the mind already. I guess it's just the mind. But then we have Book of Belial, but we also have the goat head, you know? A lot of things are kind of made redundant on this run. No demon judgment. This is Necropolis 2, Depths 2, yeah. Okay. Tell you what, let's start by going up to our item room here. Might as well, because we can see everything, we might as well choose, like, the route with the least amount of backtracking. It's a shitty life to be a host that spawns after, like, the doors have already opened. They can just walk out, and they're like, wait, where are you going? How did you know my secret to literally phase me out of fucking existence? It's a sad story, man. Anemia. I get it wrong every time, but anemic is just okay. Like, okay at best. Trying to save some bombs. Normally, we're not this low on bombs at this point in the game, but trying to save some just in the hopes that we can find a tinted rock, which maybe would be a little bit more viable than blowing up two blue fires. It could even give us the small rock, which would be damage that at this point would be very, very worthwhile for me. Again, could use Book of Belial on this room, but this is really like Daddy Longlegs, Attack Fly's time to shine. Daddy Longlegs in general is going to carry us a long way on this run. You can get away with having a lot less damage than you'd... Fuck. A lot less damage than you'd otherwise be able to as a result of it. So I'm going to save Book of Belial for the boss trap room that we have here. Not boss rush, where are you going? I was hoping we'd do a little bit more damage there. That's more along the lines of what I'm looking for. Again, apologies, I know my voice is a little quiet, a little hoarse. I'm a little under the weather. Yeah, this is worth it. And this is also a good opportunity because we're getting to the point where there's going to be less items per floor until the chest. So this is a good chance to test how much damage we're actually doing against, you know, what is basically going to be a standard room type pretty soon. A couple bosses, or one boss even. Like, one monster or two is going to become a pretty normal room pretty soon. And it's not looking too bad, but I think this also might be the version of Monster 02 that is, like, a little simpler. Little less tanky, I should say. Still a little bit surprised that we haven't gotten another guppy item, but I guess that's, you know, it, when you prioritize angel rooms, that is wont to happen sometimes. Be interesting to see how different. I mean, we showed the seed, right? I hope we showed the seed. Maybe we didn't show the seed. BSWW A9AB. I'll try to remember that this one's like half hour into the video. If you ever see a seed or like a video where in the description I say there's no seed, and then in the seed there or in the video there actually is a seed shown, just tweet me and I'll do my best to get it in there as soon as possible. It's a one man operation here, and you know my primary job is actually recording these videos that you see, so you know, don't be too bent out of shape if it takes a couple of hours or whatever for me to see the tweet. Keep time zones in mind as well. You know, I don't have like a Euro division of Northern Lion Inc. that's operating on CST or anything like that. But I'll do my best to handle that admin stuff and make sure that it's handled appropriately. Don't really want to use bombs to get more money here, because it seems completely worthless. At least we know we're not fighting greed here. I'll buy a fanny pack, I'll buy the coin purse, and I'll buy this. I wanted to buy the coin purse just to see if maybe we got another balls of steel. Bad trip. Full health. Range down. Tears up. It was still worth it. 7 cents for one tears up is fine, as far as I'm concerned. And our donation machine broke in one hit. Could be worse. Well, literally, that's the mathematical worst for a donation machine, but, you know. Could have been hit by a bus while we were doing it. Health up. Health up. Finally get some HP. Full health. Range down. It's alright, I want to trade this HP away. At least we can trade something away that's not our, you know, our spirit hearts, which are, in a sense, our lifeblood right now. Again, should be pretty easy. Thank you, Daddy Longlegs. Every time I say Daddy Longlegs, a little picture of, like, a smiling Joseph Gordon-Levitt shows up in my brain. I don't know what that says about me. I think it's that it's, like, you know, Daddy Longlegs is, like, DLL, and Joseph Gordon-Levitt is, like, JGL. It's all messed up. I'm not ashamed to admit that here, you know, live in front of 50,000 people. What's the problem? A deal with the angel again. Please, God. Godhead. Breath of freaking life, huh? Well, you know, I'll pick it up and put it back down. That's not a good item, in case you didn't know. But all we need is, like, one really over-the-top angel item. That would help out a lot. Oh, sweet, I still have more water. Godhead. Frig. I'd take the ability to fly. Sorry for using such strong language right there. Like, Dead Dove, Holy Grail, Halo, I'd be all over that stuff. Definitely going to go to... Ooh, we can play this, like, once. Tell you what, let's try this. It didn't work! That's alright, it already basically paid for itself. I fucked that up, could have saved a bomb. Guppy item. It's still pretty good. Nothing there. We're moving on. Not Mr. Fred, which is kind of surprising. There is a tinted rock. Come on, small rock. Come on, small rock. Worth it. I mean, we basically broke even plus got a spirit heart, which I guess means that we didn't at all break even. We actually came out ahead. Should have used, absolutely should have used Book of Belial on that room. Now we're a little bit too close to the boss, unless we want to do some extra rooms, which I'm not super interested in. But I'll probably go to our second secret room, so I'm full of shit. I could have used Book of Belial on this room. Pop up. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Alright. Really hoping for, like, a fallen fight again. I don't think it could happen. Just please don't make me slash let me fight Conquest. Balls of Steel is so good. Health up is also pretty good if we actually get a deal with the devil. If we don't, it's better than not having it, I guess, if we're already in the non-Boolean state, or, like, we're on the false equivalent of the Boolean state of having permanent Polaroid invincibility, so we might as well be content with this. It's looking increasingly like we're gonna win this run, if you weren't already a believer. Basically a full health card there. Probably could have used it to some more creative effect, abusing that blood bank somehow. Okay, I'm mostly just excited that we're still in this and doing pretty well. It's always a privilege. That was terrible damage on my part. I can't really offer much in my own defense here. Alright, the bloat. That's fine. Not my favorite boss. You know, a little tricky. No question about that, but if we can just get Daddy Longlegs to hit him at the right opportunity, it's pretty good. Sneak in there occasionally. That might do it right there. Okay, good stuff. Now a deal with the devil. Another deal with the angel. And Pageant Boy, that's going to be an enormous help for us late in the game here, especially now that we have the Steam sale as well. Imagine the purchasing power we have. Nun's Habit. Nun's Habit is good, but not really good enough for me to be happy. It's good enough to take, obviously, but not great. Curse of the Unknown. On this floor, we should be slightly more vigilant. We got a couple of interesting rooms except our, like, in addition to our boss room that I'd like to take advantage of. Remember, we still have one more, at least one more guaranteed deal. Angel or devil. And it'll be on the cathedral, which is coming up very, very shortly here. But let's go to our mob trap room first. Oh, we can't because I have too much HP. Right. Well, I'm actually relatively happy to be fighting Wrath. Because I'm low on bombs. So yeah, even picking up a few bombs in the key is just icing on the cake here. But picking up a few bombs, well worth it. I'm going to go down to our curse room. Curse of the Unknown freaks me out a little bit, but I'm still going to go down to our curse room because there's still a... Thanks to this Joker card, there's still a relatively, you know, non-zero chance that we can actually become Guppy, which is a... That would be a huge help for my, you know, overall confidence in this run, which is still pretty high. You know, we've won harder runs than this for sure. Alright. That's alright. Spirit Heart. Give me a Spirit Heart back or something. Single penny. All the single pennies, all the single pennies, largely useless lately, largely useless lately. Surprisingly hard to enunciate that. With a gland the size of a hazelnut in your, under your jaw. I'll take another health upgrade because I'm pretty sure at this point we've lost, well, we definitely lost some spirit hearts on that cursed room. So I can afford to have another HP capacity there. And admittedly, hematemesis, there's some fun implications of that. That we can use, but I'm not going to use them because I'd rather just stick with our Joker card here. Able pickup is not my favorite out of that golden chest pool, but it's not bad necessarily. No demon judgment, could play the blood bank and get the ability to go into that mob trap room. You want to try that? I think we can do it like twice at least. Thank you, fanny pack. And we'll try this out. This is going to be a little bit cumbersome, and I hope I didn't cost myself any spirit hearts in the process. Basically, we're going to go play the blood bank once, and then we're going to come back down here, and the door's open. So I may have cost myself a spirit heart or timed it perfectly. I think it was worth it. We got a tears upgrade out of it. I'm not going to use Book of Belial here because we're already over halfway through it. Daddy Longlegs is really just running away with it here. Yeah, we're doing a decent amount of damage, and the tiers upgrades have really helped, so... I do think this room is worth it in a weird way. We'll see if we get something interesting back at the end of it. All the single pennies, all the single pennies. Completely useless lately, not largely useless anymore. Alright, we can't fly, correct. We can now use a hematemesis pill, which is probably a good idea. You're also now about to witness the strength of street knowledge. Half heart might slash should put me at a half heart interval, which is theoretically good for a couple of reasons. You know, permanent Polaroid invincibility once when we're near death, but when we get that permanent Polaroid invincibility, even if we're on the Curse of the Unknown floor, we will know that we're almost dead. So there's value in that. Justice card with the extra spirit art pickup, very nice. Maybe we can even use this Joker card conveniently on our cathedral, because we have the mind. Oh, we should definitely go to our second secret room. But we can maybe use this card conveniently to get ourselves out of a curse room and save one more spirit heart. We wouldn't get our deal right away, which is something I always prefer to do. Thank you, Revengefly, by the way, for finally taking your part there. I guess that's the awesome part of this run. When we get hit, we've got a Celtic Cross chance for invincibility. And that... Ooh. Gives us a good crack at some good stuff here. Doing some extra damage with our orbitals, but for now, pop this bad boy down here. I still want to believe in the Guppy Dream. This is getting a little ridiculous. I know we're probably pushing some spirit hearts away. That helps. And that might help, but... It's becoming a weirdly vanilla-esque run, which is just my way of saying... We got a lot of HP and not necessarily a lot of damage. So this was actually the kind of room I was looking for to hopefully do this. I don't know if we need spirit hearts right now. Like, we might be at the HP cap. We're not. Are we gonna fight Mega Satan? I'd like to try to fight Mega Satan. It depends on how the run looks to some extent. That's not necessarily worth it, but we will be able to accomplish my agreed upon dream here. I don't have to come back through this room, right? Like, if I just bomb my way out, I'm gone forever. Yeah, unless we get Curse of the Maze, in which case I'll be pissed. But, you know, my number one priority is not just, like, dying to Mega Satan. If we could also win the run, that would be great. Devil card's pretty good. We'll come back for that one. No secret room to get into the curse room, so we will take damage on the way in. And on the way out, actually. Now that I think about it, it doesn't really matter if we use our Joker card right away. Oh, you motherfuckers. It doesn't really matter if we use our Joker card right away, because we have to go out of the room. We also have to fight this room, but it's a little bit less annoying than the death side, or than the death, I think. Mr. Mega, no big deal. It's actually Super Envy, sorry, Super Wrath, but Mr. Mega sounds like a great name for him, I think you got to admit. What's up, Daddy Longlegs? You still you doing work for me up here? I certainly hope so. You're on the clock. All right, four bombs. Well, we might as well find our secret room while we're up here. All the single pennies, this time there's a trio. All the single pennies, not technically single pennies. Please let me in this time. All right, spirit hearts and the guppy item. Spirit heart and hanged man. It doesn't matter if we Joker card now, so I'm just gonna do it now. Man, Dark Matter is not the not the enormous coup that I was expecting there. But what's done is done. I'm not gonna sweat it. We're just gonna try to win now. We've done our part. I think except for the nail. Oh, should not have done that. I was even thinking about it. I was like, I wonder where he's gonna jump because of that fear shot. Except for that deal with the devil room where they had the nail and Spirit of the Night, not Spirit of the Night, Lord of the Pit, and I chose not to take it. I think we did everything within our power to get as strong as possible on this run, so. And we're not in a terrible position, it's just maybe a little bit suboptimal. I won't feel bad if we lose this one, even though we've got the tools for victory, because I think that RNG was a little bit anti-Judas on this run. Although we do have the mind, which is pretty great. But Judas starts with enough advantages, I think, that we got a pretty good shot at this. Mostly due to those HP upgrade pills, which were admittedly extremely good luck. We can't fly. We can't fly. Thank you. I was waiting for Fear Shot to freeze him completely. At that point, I didn't even want a guppy item unless it was... I don't even know if I would take 9 lives right now. This run's got a whole fucked up meta as a result of it being a strange-ass run. Alright, this is a big one. I don't know when we're going to use Hanged Man, by the way. Let me fight some enemies that create creep on the chest. Not good damage. Very bad damage. Where's my Celtic Crosses at? Thank you, Revengefly, by the way. Revengefly is quietly going to be like one of the best items for us right here. I think people, you know, by and large, everyone's drinking the Kool-Aid on Revengefly. But you should drink the Kool-Aid. Drinking the Kool-Aid gets a bad rap, but sometimes the Kool-Aid is fucking delicious. Yes, I understand the origin of the phrase, drinking the Kool-Aid of the Jonestown Massacre, etc., etc. Oh, we made it. I'm just trying to say, you know, cherry Kool-Aid can be pretty delicious. If you know that you're not likely to be poisoned as a result of drinking it, maybe it's drinking the Kool-Aid's not so bad. Yeah, Spoonbender's great. Undefined can be awesome. Are we going to get rid of Book of Belial for this? I think yes, just because it's ridiculous, and we have the keys necessary to do so. So let's start farming Undefined here to hopefully get error rooms. I don't really want to fight Blue Baby. Like, if we're going to be doing Undefined chest runs to try to get stronger, we might as well just fight Mega Satan. Although, now that I think about it, are we actually going to be able to fight Mega Satan? Because we've already used the key. We don't have Dad's key anymore. This might actually screw us out of being able to fight Mega Satan. What do people want to see more? An Undefined chest run or a Mega Satan run? I think people would rather see an Undefined chest run, and I would rather do an Undefined chest run. So I'm going to adhere to that, and hopefully Dad's key will just be like an ever-present effect. Although, not Dad's key, but you know what I mean. The key that we put together will be an ever-present effect. Can't guarantee it, though. If so, I apologize, but, you know, sometimes absurdities exclude other absurdities. Sometimes I can even, speak English properly, which is good considering it's literally the only language I do speak, except for a little bit of GML. And a lot of GMM. I think those guys are real funny. I mean, it's a good card. I don't really want to fight him right now. We'll save it for later. Give me, like, a keybagger, then I can go back for the Mega Satan fight and just get a lot of items this way. All right. All the single keys still talking, single keys. Large. Now, they're not even keys. They're actually pennies. Not paninis. Don't get me hungry right now. I got another few videos to record today. Oh, there was a tractor beam effect there. I was like, man, I got really slow all of a sudden. Right? I can't fly. Okay, I just whiffed on that one big time. I was like, I can't do this properly. Oh, there we go. Error room. No extra items. We're about to see if this works. Just give me a moment here. Frame rate might dip for just a second here. Oh, yeah. Look at that effect. Are we back, baby? Yeah, we're back. Okay. No dad's key. That sucks. But on the other hand, we did get rubber cement Sagittarius scissors 10 bombs. I don't really want the scissors. They're okay, though. But rubber cement Sagittarius is pretty... It's a wild combination. I think rubber cement in some ways breaks piercing. But still worth it. And we'll keep trying to farm on the find as long as we can get extra items. But this should definitely be a win now. The longer we farm on the find, the better chance... Well, it's going to depend on our keys, of course. But the better chance we actually have to find the actual item of Dad's key. Which would be... that would be nice for us. If I was just gunning for the win, we would just easily come up here to our boss fight and finish that shit off ASAP. I didn't even see you blended in with your own creep there, you sly so-and-so. I actually immediately regretted coming into this room because it was large and we didn't have any necessarily need to. But then I got hit twice on it and now I'm like, alright, perfect. Sun card is probably the most useful for us. Sure, we'll take this, do a little bit more farming here. Heading to the country, gonna buy a bunch of peaches. There goes our Eternal Heart. This is why we got the Sun card, though, to back us up here. We're already halfway to our next charge. If we wanted to, we could go really hard when we, like, run out of natural charges and just start, like, filling the charges ourselves by getting hit, which is probably a terrible idea. But could potentially get the job done, and we have the Sun card to back us up in a pinch. I hope we don't need to use it. That was just terrible play on my part there. But we're ready. Secret room. Not sure what I was expecting there, to be honest with you. Good card here. That's not a good card. Not a terrible item, but not a particularly good, you know, playing card. You couldn't play blackjack with that. You might be able to play Pinochle. I don't know what Pinochle actually is, but I know that it's a great punchline for a joke as a result of the fact that the word sounds like Pinochle. I really thought those were going to hit me. Do we, Oh, we've already been to our second secret room. That's where we got the Eternal Heart, of course. Terrible damage again. Give me a blood bang or something, so instead of taking this damage, I can at least take some, like, productive damage. If we get a hit here, it actually wouldn't be the worst thing in the world, because I could use the Sun card as a Necronomicon effect. Very sloppy play on the chest here, but I'm feeling like we got a pretty sensibly predictable win here, regardless. And we have, like, all of the items that I like for synergies, except, like, a technology of some sort. It's our second secret room again. We're running out of natural rerolls here. I don't know. I might have to tap out on this run soon. It's not by choice, but rather by... I'm being forced into it by the lack of... the lack of an error room, really. Nothing more elegant to say than that. And maybe it's just giving me a chance to farm up even more keys than usual. That way, I can go through, like, 8 more I Am Error rooms. So far, so good. Let's be honest, I'm probably going to get hit on the big room. I probably should have been hit right there as well, but I didn't. In a weird way, I think this is a synergy that looks really cool, but might not be that cool, because I believe that with rubber cement... thank you for not being envies. I believe that with rubber cement... shots can deal more than one hit to an enemy, but they have to bounce off a wall first. But they're not really going to have a great chance to bounce off a wall as a result of the fact that Spoonbender is just going to pull them right back in. But maybe there's an exception here. I know that we have the Undefined ready. I just wanted to kill this room so I didn't have to do it again. I think that's going to probably do it. I can't afford to hurt myself too much and then farm up hits. Let's just go through that big room, try to kill Blue Baby. If after Blue Baby, this room's fine. If after Blue Baby, I have been hit enough to get a charge, I'll try Undefined once more, but I wouldn't get your hopes up. You know, I've tried. I failed. The lesson is never try. How are you still alive? I was going to say, like, I didn't want to play chicken with you, but I knew you were one or two hits away from dying. Not really doing quite as much damage as I would expect here, especially considering we are Dark Judas right now. It's like slightly below average for a regular run. For a Dark Judas run, it's just, I wouldn't say embarrassing, but it's a mark of personal shame that I didn't get a little bit more damage anyway. Mr. Boom, I mean, technically better to take on to this boss fight. No reason to use the Hanged Man, but also, you know, in my opinion, no reason really not to. Trying to throw down these Bob's Curse shots. It's not working out that fantastically right now. We're still going to win, and we're actually like one hit away from having a charge. Man, Revenge Fly is so good. Ah, there we go. I got frozen there. That's all right. Let's use it one more time. I knew it. I knew the game wouldn't let me get off that easily. I was so ready for that to be the end, but that's all right. More synergies. Relics, amazing. Wafers, amazing. Sack of pennies is amazing, and we still got a decent number of keys. Fear Shot, My Reflection, 2020. It's actually Charm Shot, by the way. But My Reflection 2020, adding a lot of weird synergy to our tiers here. Kind of automatically. D20, Technology. So I'm immediately going to break some of our synergies to take Technology 2, because I love Technology 2 Spoonbender. I know it's going to lower our damage, and I was just complaining about that, but the Spoonbender effect, I think, more than makes up for it. It's too cool. Yeah. Anytime I can get this opportunity, I'm going to take it. I mean, damage is the stat that matters. However, it also matters if you can actually hit enemies. And, you know, even if our damage sucks, if we're able to hit enemies, like, literally every, you know, 10 times a second when I'm holding the button down, then that's a great win for us. Now I just want more technologies. Give me Tech 1 and Tech 2. Give me Tech 9 for all I care. Plus, sweet-ass neon effects on Curse of the Darkness floors. This being said, we would really benefit from having a little bit more HP. I'm a little nervous about that. Be a bad way to lose a streak. That helps, I appreciate it. I'm not actually that nervous about this run. Like, I don't think we're gonna lose it. But I think we could lose it. We're probably like, the relic and the wafer, exactly. They help out a ton there. Let's kill Pestilence first here just to further increase our odds, because we'll get, I think that's Blue Famine. It's kind of hard to tell with the weird lighting effects and the color of our own tears, but yeah, there you go. That helps a ton. Devil. It's not going to hurt. Well, it's not going to hurt me, at least. If we can get into a situation where we can hit both these guys at the same time, that would be good for business. Revenge Fly helping out a ton, as always. Celtic Cross not hurting. Here we go again. Yeah, Demon Baby for free, absolutely. I'll buy the battery charge, but I don't really want to buy anything else. I'll buy the Spirit Heart. I didn't take Demon Baby. Ah, man. Well, that's, let's be honest, relatively minor in the whole scheme of things. The real thing is that we're getting the extra four items. Sad Onion, Isaac's Heart, Monstro's Lung. It's weird, but I'll take it. Isaac's Heart could get us killed, but I'll take it. Same Sad Onion. I'm assuming basically lets us tap shot, to some extent, Monstro's Lung. There's our second secret room. All right, oh my god. I can't tell if this is amazing, but it sort of feels amazing, but maybe just because these enemies suck. Like, this is looking pretty sweet, right? I'm not in the minority on that one. Are you seeing how the tears just hover around, like, whatever enemy they find? I don't know if they continue to do damage like that, but man, I'm okay with it either way. Yeah, okay, I'm glad that Undefined stuck it out with us here. I appreciate that. Didn't have to do that. Another devil card. Gotta wait for all the tears to dissipate so I can put down this bomb. Any minute now. There we go. Alrighty then. Curse of the Maze. Pleasure as always. Might as well take our one bomb. And now I'm starting to feel this run. Like, this run's making me feel pretty good. Should probably be killing Dark... Yeah, this is Dark One. Should probably be killing Dark One a little faster than this, but whatever. Oh my god, another I Am Air Room and four free items. So the X-Ray Goggles will help out. I have no idea how Strange Attractor is going to work for us here. We're definitely not going to take Kamikaze. But we'll take X-Ray Vision, which will save us some bombs. But now we're running out of keys, so if we get to the boss, we're just going to go for it. Mulligan is great. Magic Fingers, you know, theoretically great, but we're not going to take it because we want on the fine charges still. Yeah, this is an excellent series of pickups here. Whoa, a little bit of knock. That's not even knockback. That's like knock forward. There's a key on that last room. I just couldn't see it because of the, you know, Strange Attractor's weird-ass business here. Which I think is a Miyazaki film. Strange Attractor's weird-ass business? Anybody? Mueller? It's not like Miyazaki's, like, obscure or anything. I don't know what I'm trying to say there. I don't like this famine anymore. That was a little weird. I can't even see what the consumables are. There's a tarot card in here. So there we go. We got it. The devil. Adversary. How quick does the adversary go down? It's a good metric for our potential damage here. Tammy's head would be such a hilarious pickup. What are these pills? 48-hour energy anywhere? Tears Up is great. Balls of Steel is nice. Mad Trip could save our lives. We should actually probably roll with that. Oh my god, it happened again, and they gave us keys this time. I think I'd rather get, like, direct chests than key beggars, but you get the idea. Now we have nowhere to go. I don't really want to take Epic Fetus, but Common Cold... That's not even Epic Fetus, it's Dr. Fetus. But Common Cold and the Virus are fine here. Any more tier effects we get are awesome in my book. And now we have enough keys to do this shit one more time. If we could just get... Where's the key? Oh, we got it already. Okay. Balls of Steel. I need Bad Trip back. There we go. Well, now I kind of hope we get an I Am Air Room. Because I don't want to deal with... I don't want to deal with Curse of the Lost. I'm also taking, like, staggering amount of damage, like, largely directly due to Strange Attractor. But that's okay, because it's so fun and ridiculous, and we have the Wafer and the Relic anyway, right? Oh, there's a Spirit Heart in there. Okay, there's one. We still have the keys necessary, so I wouldn't mind if we actually managed to... get another charge, but with Curse of the Lost, it's a little annoying. There's another key. We'll go back for it. Oh, that's sweet. We're cute. This is like a Ghostbusters run right now. Like, we just keep them on the line as we zap them. It looks sweet as hell. Plus, we're getting so many undefined charges thanks to taking so much damage with Nuns Have It. They're caught in our fucking proton pack right now. I guess we'll fight Blue Baby, and if we don't teleport to the air room... with our next charge, we'll just finish the run. It's a fun one, though. This is like a really, really fun one. Which is kind of crazy, because I'm not going to say it didn't start out as not being fun, but it didn't really start out as being that incredible. It was really like the... Even though we didn't get to fight Mega Satan, the undefined plays made up for it in the end. That was a good time. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. We'll be back with an Eden Run next. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, click the like button. Helps out a great deal, and of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.